Vandaag de top stories. Verdelende liederen klink op bij die Zulu konings xenofobie in Bizo. Kan geheuverlies die builmoordzaak kelder? En hoe hou miskryers koers? Ons hek, hulle navigatiestelsel. Goeiemiddag, ex Elma Smit. Drieën sang dat buitenlanders al rij moet krijgen, het vanochtend opgeklinkt bij die Zulu koning Goodwill Zwelithini se xenofobie in Bizo bij die Moses Mabhida stadion in Durban. Amanda Koza is daar. Amanda, please give us a sense of what's happening.
Amabuto, which are the regiment, they are men clad in Zulu traditional regalia. They have been singing songs since we arrived at the stadium. Some of the songs, ironically, are against the reason why we have gathered here today. They have an xenophobic tone or notes to it, because some are saying, "Izele tuleli, this is our nation. Why are we sharing with other nationalities?" That's what one of the residents explained to me when I asked him, "What does the song mean?"
Thank you, Amanda. James Outway, die Sunday Times fotograaf wat hierdie aanval op Emmanuel Setole saterdag in Alexandra afgeneem het, praat nou met ons. James, critics are saying you should have prevented the attack on this Mozambican national instead of watching it happen.
I was holding a camera and not a gun. I don't think there is any way that I could have stopped that gang of armed men from desisting from attacking Emmanuel. The whole thing happened very quickly. Took about 2 minutes from start to finish. And I do think that my presence there did deter the attack. I think it would have been a much more brutal scene had I not been there. It was definitely xenophobia. The fact he had nothing stolen from him. Also the determination on the faces of the attackers. You could see that they weren't going to stop until they had tasted Emmanuel's blood. I think I'm still in a little bit of a state of shock. You know, I'm really upset that Emmanuel did pass away and that we weren't able to save him. But at the same time, I'm quite satisfied these pictures have created such a uproar.
Die volledige onderhoud met Outway is beskikbaar op ons multimedia blad. Marley van Breda kan blijkbaar nog niks onthou van die builaanval op haar en haar familie bijna 3 maanden geleden nie. Een persverklaring lui dat sy aan retrograde geheuverlies lui. Ons gesels nou met die neurosielkundige Elspeth Burke oor die toestand.
It depends on the severity of the brain injury. Generally accepted that the brain takes 2 years to reach its maximum recovery. Mm. If a brain injury is very severe, then the period of retrograde amnesia is longer. Mm. If it is only the brain injury is mild, you'll have a shorter period of retrograde amnesia. We cannot give any definitive answer now, but she's still very much in the recuperation phase. Mm. I could tell you the likelihood if it's a severe brain injury, she won't remember.
Dankie, Elspeth. Is daar so iets soos 'n onskadelike vriendskap tussen 'n getroude man en 'n ander vrou? Die NG Kerk se ondersoek na die egskeiding en beweerde affairs van sy voormalige moderator, professor Piet Strauss, begin vandag. Strauss het die naweek geskerm dat hy en 'n sielkundige Sharon Strijd net 'n sterk emosionele band deel. Greta Wiet het met ons gesels hieroor.
Ek dink is 'n baie fyn lyn. Ek dink nie, dis 'n gesonde terrein vir enige huwelik nie. Ek wat Greta is, sou ongemaklik wees, en ek weet dat duisende ander hulle self saam met my sal skaar. En net sê, as my man met my eerlik is daaroor, as ek weet, dit is nie 'n intieme gesprek en so meer nie, dan voel ek al gemakliker, maar ek voel nog steeds nie gerus nie. My blote antwoord is, ja, ek dink, dis 'n fyn lyn, maar nee. Ek dink nie, daar behoort iets te bestaan soos 'n emosionele verhouding tussen 'n man wat getroud is met 'n vrou met wie hy nie getroud is.
Om naar die rest van my gesprek met Greta Wiet te kyk, klik op ons multimedia blad. Die meeste mense het waarskynlik al 'n miskryer so op 'n misbal sien dans. Wat dink jy doen hierdie oukie? Navigeer hy met behulp van die son en die melkweg? Probeer hy roofdiere afskud? Of is dit 'n paringsdans? Volgens professor Marcus Byrne van Witse Skool van Diereplant en Omgevingswetenskappe is dit hoe die miskryer homself oriënteer. Hy navigeer na aanleiding van die son, die melkweg en selfs polarisasiepatrone. Dit als om sy stukkie mis op 'n veilige plek te bewaar. Gaan kyk gerus na die res van hierdie fascinerende insetsel op ons multimedia blad.